sphere mesh filter, and it's going to like create a sphere out of it. Okay, so I don't know which kind of patterns, like you can, for example, start a mask from here, increase the distortion, not that much, create some loops, not that, yeah, something like this. And now you can like create another mask from here and increase the probably a lot more loops and increase the distortion and flip it and enable gradients and preserve. So now you can go to the filter and just like, if you set it to inflate, you kind of can start making these kinds of shapes, like kind of cracks or whatever. Like you can make this look even more interesting, like depending on what you want. If you change the texture to magic, like the distortion is going to be different. It's like, see? More loops. And again, this is not in master yet enabled by default, but you need to think that these kinds of patterns, I'm using them with the mesh filter, but when ScalVertex colors are enabled, there's a tool that is called the color filter. So if you set this to color and you use vertex, you can actually like fill that area in one color and then invert the mask and fill the other area in other color and kind of get these patterns instantly. In fact, Expand is prepared to work directly with ScalVertex colors. Like the code is already there, it's not enabled. But all the options you can do with the mask, like the gradients, recursions, flipping, gradient, whatever, they work exactly the same way with vertex colors. But that is going to be enabled in the future. But for now, it's like, you can just, I don't know, if you want to like create a gradient in this colorful sphere from here, gradient, create a mask, flip it, gradient, you have this gradient, you invert it, you go to the color filter and you change like the hue, and you kind of introduce some color variation through the surface there. If you want like to add another pattern on top of this, like create, I don't know, more loops or distort it again, like this, and let's add another color, I don't know. So yeah, it's like, this is kind of the point of having the filters, and why the filters were like not really useful until now, but now you can do you can see everything you can do with them. Okay, so now I'm going to like try to do the final demo, like using all the features I show you, which I call like pack the watermelon, which okay, it's like I'm going to use Expand to do things, the watermelon. Okay, start from a sphere and let's delete this topology because like scale mode and Blender and modeling in general don't really like poles. Okay, extrude, shift T. Okay, so now we have something like this, and I'm going to like rip one of the vertices, like one of the loops. Going to create a ScalVertex color layer, and I'm going to add a couple of subdivisions just to have more resolution in the paint. Okay, so now from scale mode, you can start with Expand, creating some things. First, let's fill the watermelon with kind of green color. Okay. And now I'm going to take a brush and I'm going to use a texture distortion pattern for making the strips of the watermelon. So brush, I create a new one and I set it to 3D. And the kind of pattern is probably okay. So you know that when you span from the boundary, it's going to make this, and you can increase the... Don't crash, please. You can increase the number of loops in the watermelon. Something like this. And you are going to distort everything. Not that much. Many less distortion. Yeah, this is fine. Okay, so now we have the mask. You can go to the color filter, go to value, and make that a little bit darker and a little bit more. Let's see how it looks without the overlay. A little bit more saturated, maybe. Darker. And not that hue. Yeah. Good enough watermelon. Okay, and if you don't really like that seam, it's like, you can really go to the paintbrush and paint it away. It's not a big deal. And if you want to get back like a perfect sphere from the subdivisions, you go to the sphere mesh filter. And it's going to have like a perfect watermelon sphere. Okay, so now we have the watermelon, and now we are going to pack the watermelon. So let's create a paper for packing the watermelon. Probably this is enough paper. Okay, going to subdivide it. Probably like this is good enough. And I'm going to add a collision mesh. I'm not using the watermelon directly because it's kind of a high poly mesh, and like the kind of collisions the cloth solver uses are like quite depending on the resolution of the collider. So it's like for a sphere, using a sphere with this amount of polygons, it's perfectly fine. And you can like set the visibility in the viewport to something lower, like wire. Okay, let's save just in case, because things can go really wrong from here. Okay, so now I'm going to measure like the paper more or less, and I know I want like to split it in 9 segments, so I'm going to expand the faces from here. I'm going to create a recursion so the watermelon is in the middle. Yeah, probably like that. Going to expand another faces from here. I'm going to create another recursion with the watermelon in the middle, something like that. And to preserve, so I see that both. Okay. Now, this is a feature that's only my experimental development branch, but the coding master is planned and is ready for getting it. If you start expanding a mask from the boundary, it is going to position the pivot exactly in the boundary of the expansion, which is ready for taking the transform tool and doing this. And again, we can go through the other side, and we can use the transform tool with deformation targets that's coming eventually, and do it like this. Now we can continue packing the watermelon, like from here, you can just bend it there, and from here, you can just bend it like this. Okay, so now we want to close the bug. So we can create like an array of action for the filter by taking these vertices and taking these vertices. And we want these two to be the same array of action for the cloth filter. So with expand, you can edit the facets, take this one and merge it with the other. And now they are the same. So now you can go to the cloth filter, set it to pinch, set it to use the facets without any auto masking option, and with a little bit more damping, and you can pinch the bag and close it. Yeah. And you can like flick a little bit of the clipping. Here and there. Okay, let's fix the normals and set this to a smooth shading. After smoothing is like, this is not really visible, but yeah, the important part is done. Okay, and now I'm going to like create another plane, go here, and do the decorations. Again, expand from there, you go to facet edit, you go to delete geometry, not expand from there with a recursion step, go to the filter, pinch, use facets, pinch there. Perfect. You can go to the pose brush now and you can like make this a little bit different with the pen tool. You can shade smooth and you can make it bigger and put it like here. And let's say we want to make this a little bit more interesting, so subdivision surface. Let's add more resolution. And I don't know, let's add a vertex color layer to the packing, and let's expand another mask pattern, and I'm going to do a bunch of recursion steps, probably with another shape so it looks a little bit more random. I'm going to start it in a spherical mode, and I'm going to start the recursion step from there. Exactly, this looks more random, something like this. Okay, and now I'm going to the color filter and I'm going to like invert them. No, probably like this is okay. So yeah, now you kind of have a better understanding of expand and everything it does and what you can do with it. So it's like, this should give you like more ideas on how you can work with it and the kind of things that now scale modes enable you to do. Let's add more frills. It's like, in general, Blender has a lot of tools to make frills because that's something I need a lot for my eye style. So yeah, it's like, if you want to make frills, like Blender has you covered. Okay, so I don't know, I'm going to look at the chat for the first time in the entire stream. I don't know if I should like reply to some questions or if I should end the stream now, whatever. Let's ask the communication manager. Or if the questions were supposed to be somewhere, and if that is okay, I think this was it. Okay, so about symmetry. Yeah, the symmetry options are the same options as in regular scale mode. If you enable X symmetry or Y symmetry, I don't know. Like expand automatically detects that and start expanding the shapes symmetrically. But yeah, it's like, I think this was long enough. Hope you like it and you have like a better understanding on the design of and what you kind the kind of functionality you can expect out of Blender and why is this useful? It's like,